everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another surface of revolution problem. And the function that we're given is y squared minus z squared equals 1. And they've asked us to rotate around the z-axis. So, as with any of these problems, the solution is fairly simple but sometimes difficult to grasp right away. I'll go ahead and put it up here. What you're going to want to do first is recognize which axis you're rotating around. So they've asked us to rotate around the z-axis, which means that we're going to completely ignore the variable z and anything else in the problem that's not a variable. So you can see down here in our solution, we've ignored this minus z squared because we're ignoring z because we're rotating around the z-axis, and we've ignored the 1. So all of this part here is going to stay. What we need to focus on is any other variable in our problem that's not z. And in this case, that's y. You'll also notice we've left the squared here, right here. So all we're looking at is this y variable right here. So in this case, what we need to do to change the y variable is you're always going to want to end up in the end of your problem with all three variables in your solution, x, y, and z. In our case, you can see we already have both y and z. As you know, we're leaving z completely alone, and we've already got y in here. So what I would recommend doing is building out your solution this way. You know you have to add in x because it's the only variable that's missing. So write out x plus y in place of y. You write out x plus y. Both of those terms are going to end up being squared. This is just the kind of the formula for surface of revolution. So you replace y with x plus y to get that third variable in there. You square both of them, so add in these squared exponents here, and then you take the square root of that sum. So you write in your square root sign here over both of those. And that whole block here, this quantity, square root of the quantity x squared plus y squared, that whole thing is what you end up replacing y with. Everything else in the problem stays the same. So that's how you set up your solution. And then your final answer, notice that we've got a squared term here and the square root sign. So of course, when you square the square root of something, the square root sign is going to go away, and you're going to end up with only what's inside the square root, which is x squared plus y squared in our case. So we pull that out. The rest of the problem stays the same, and that's your final answer. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!